Very good morning, everyone. So the previous class we finished the chapter is units and measurements is over. Then let we'll move to new chapter. That is motion in a straight line. Actually, I'll tell you one thing here. For motion in a straight line, and here in this motion in a straight line. This is related to kinematics. Sir, what is mean by kinematics? See, actually kinematics is one is there, as well as the dynamics is one is there. So the kinematics is nothing but it is the branch. Actually we are discussing the chapter name is motion in a straight line. This is the third chapter. So before going to that chapter, I'll tell you introduction part of motion in a straight line. See, that is we can say kinematics. See, there is a one chapter, it is this kinematics is contains two topics. This is the one topic is we can say motion in a straight line. Motion in a straight line, this is one chapter, and another one motion in a plane. Okay, this is the two chapters. It contains a kinematics is contains a two topics. One is we can say motion a straight line, and another one we can say motion a plane. And coming to the another one is that we can say dynamics. So the dynamics also contains, it is related to laws of motion and friction. That is there in the next topics. And before that, I'll tell you what is mean by kinematics. So the kinematics is nothing but it is the branch of physics. Actually before that, I'll tell you other statement also. So we should know about a mechanics. So the mechanics is nothing but it is a branch of physics which used to discuss about the motion of a bodies. It is a branch which related to physics, and this is a discuss or a deal with the motion of a bodies. It deal with the motion of a bodies. Motion of a bodies, right? Motion of a body. So that the mechanics is again it is classified as one we can say kinematics, that is the chapter it is, and another one we can say dynamics. Okay, this is the two chapters. Sir, what is actually mean by kinematics? See here, I'll give you about a kinematics. That is about a kinematic is nothing but here it is also branch of mechanics. Dynamics also it is a branch of mechanics. So the kinematics is nothing but it is used to discuss about a motion of a body without considering the action of force. Suppose the body is said to be in a motion, right? It is moving, you say it is moving or in motion because of some applied, that we can say some force is applied. So that the body is said to be in a motion, the body is said to be in a motion. So that kinematics is nothing but it is the branch of mechanics which used to discuss about a motion of a body without considering the action of force. In kinematics, here it is how the body is to be moving, it is not required. Just we should discuss and we should only deal the motion of a body. That is we can say kinematics. Kinematics is nothing but it is a branch of mechanics which used to discuss about a motion of a bodies without considering the action of force. Not required the force, only we will discuss about a motion of a body. This is the kinematics. And coming to the dynamics, see, dynamics is nothing but again it is also branch of physics. It is also discuss about the motion of a body. See, it is also discuss about a motion of a body, but here with considering the action of force. Here in this kinematics, it is not required the action of force, but there we will discuss the motion of a body. In case of a dynamics, here we will discuss about a motion of a body as well as the with considering the action of force. This is the dynamics. So these two statements are very very important. Kinematics is the branch of mechanics which used to discuss the motion of a body without considering the action of force. Dynamics is the branch of mechanics which used to discuss the motion of a body with considering the action of force, which we can call as a dynamics. Let we'll see In this kinematics, again about a kinematics that we should know. Here in this case, kinematics is again it is contains two topics that we can see: motion in a straight line and another one is motion in a plane. So motion in a straight line is the third chapter. Motion in a plane is the fourth chapter. See, straight line is nothing but what it is: the body which moving along a straight, or which we can also call as a horizontal motion. Everyone here. Here you remember straight line, or we can also call as a, it is a horizontal motion. Suppose the body which moving along a straight line, the straight line motion which we can call as a motion in a straight line. And the plane is nothing but the bodies which move in the plane, in a given a one plane, not in the straight line. It may be in the different directions and it may be in the straight line also, but that should be in the one plane. That we can call as a motion in a plane. Let us see. We'll see in this motion in a straight line. Let us we have different statements are there. So we'll see, see the first one actually. There is another question is there. That is a rest. And another one is motion. Sir, what are these? Rest is nothing but a. So the position of particle, it does not changes. The position of particle. Suppose if a body is at a position. Therefore, the body is to be at the same position only with respect to time. That we can say time is goes, but the body is to be in a remains in the same position. If the body is in a remains in the same position, which we can call as a rest, it does not changes the position of a particle with respect to time. That what here it is nothing but a. So the time is goes on, but the position of a particle is remains the same. Suppose if I am at rest. Like it is to be, it is to be rest only, at a same position only, but the time is going, so that we can call as a rest. Suppose the motion, is nothing but the particle which moving along a line, or the particle is displaces. See, remember, particle is displaces, or the position of a particle is changes with respect to time. That's what. If I am at rest, if I am at a position, suppose if I am moving like this, so that here we can see the motion. Because with respect to time, the motion, or we can say with respect to time, the particle is moving. The particle position is changing. That's what we can call as a, if it is motion, we can say if it is moving, and we can say at rest. Rest in the sense is does not changes position, but motion is nothing but the position of a particle is changes along a line or along a in a plane. That we can call as a motion. That's what we can call motion and rest are relatives. Explain. There is a one question for 2 marks. See, rest and motion are relatives. Explain. That's what you write here. Just rest definition and as well as motion definition. Rest is nothing but the position of particle does not changes with respect to time, and the position of particle is changes with respect to time is nothing but a motion. And here motion is straight line. Just now I finished the statement. Once again I'll tell you. Suppose the particle is moving in the stream, or the position of a particle is changes. So if a line is joining all the position of positions, if a line joining the position with respect to time, which we can call as a motion is straight line, or we can also call horizontal motion, horizontal, or we can also call rectilinear propagation. Or we can also call translatory. These all are same. Straight line motion, linear, translatory, rectilinear, horizontal motion is straight line. The meaning is same. So the particle is changing the position with respect to time. If the position of particle, if a line is joining the all positions, the line is joining the all positions, which we can call as a motion is straight line. So this is about a motion in a straight line and as well as rest and motion. Rest and motion is related to 2 marks. See, explain, like relatives. Explain why these are relatives. Yes, rest is, it is position does not changes, and motion is nothing but a position of a particle is changes with respect to time, which we can say it is rest and motion are relatives. So this is the one question for 2 marks. We'll see another one. That is, we can say. Yeah, here there is a very important is there. So motion is straight line. Before that, I'll tell you, we should know other statements also, that we can say vector and scalar. Sir, what is this vector? And what is the scalar? And another one is there, a tensor. Sir, what are all these? Actually, we have number of physical quantities in the previous chapter. Already we know. Previous chapter already we discussed the number of physical quantities like distance, displacement, velocity, area, volume, force, work, surface tension, pressure, linear momentum and momentum, angular momentum, like torque. These are all physical quantities, elasticity, modulus of elasticity, Young's modulus. So like we have number of physical quantities are there. So this all physical quantities are classified as three groups. So the one group we can say vector group, and then another group we can say scalar group, and one more group we can say tensor. Sir, what are this? See, you remember, based on their magnitude, based on their magnitude and direction, okay, based on their magnitude and direction, therefore that can be classified as three groups. One is the vector, scalar and tensor. And you remember, this all quantities major are related to vector and scalar. Tensor is actually, we have 3-4 are there. Sir, what is vector? I'll give you again the statement. Vector is nothing but a, you remember, which has here it is, which has both magnitude and direction. Which has both magnitude and direction, which has in the sense is physical quantity. The physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction is nothing but we can call as a vector. So we can also take like this, vector is equal to, we can say vector is equal to magnitude into direction. You remember it is. See, the magnitude in the sense is a value. See, it's a numerical value. And coming to the scalar, which has only magnitude but not a direction. In the sense is, the direction it may be zigzag, you remember. So the direction may be zigzag, it is, we can say not a direction in the sense is, yes, direction is there, but it may be zigzag in the way zigzag, we can say. And tensor is nothing but a which a physical quantity has a different magnitudes and different directions. You say different directions. So this is, we can say scalar and vector and a tensor. You remember, vector is nothing but a which has both magnitude and direction. That we can say the quantity which has magnitude as well as direction. And your scalar is nothing but a which has only magnitude but not direction. But not a direction in the sense is, direction may be zigzag. Yes, direction will be there, but it is may be zigzag. And your tensor is nothing but a physical quantity has different magnitudes and different directions. So I'll give you, these are the statements. In this statement, the vector is related to, we have number of physical quantities under comes vector. And here next comes in the scalar. And the tensor is nothing but we have 3-4 quantities. One example is, we can say inertia. Second example, moment of inertia. Third example, stress. Fourth example, strain, like this. But whereas the vector is nothing but a displacement is the vector. Velocity is the vector. Acceleration is the vector, because which has magnitude and direction. Like momentum is a vector, linear momentum. Force is a vector. Scalars are nothing but area, volume, distance, speed, mass, weight, density, temperature, like it is, so on it is. So that the vector and the scalar are the major groups, tensor is a less group, no problem. So we'll see. First of all, about a vector is over, and scalar is over, and tensor is over. If you remember these definitions, and it is help you in the coming topics. Clear? Vector is which has both magnitude and direction, and scalar is which has only magnitude but not direction. Tensor is which have physical quantity has different magnitude and different directions. Clear? And coming to the point is, you remember, this is a very, very important. If you know these statements, and it is help you in the upcoming chapters also. Right, vector, actually it is a very, very important chapter. Now we'll see, let us, we'll move to, in this first definition, already rest and motion is over, as well as the straight line is also over, and we'll move to distance. Distance, or we can also call path length. Path length is the one. See, distance and displacement, I'll tell you at a time two statements. Distance and displacements are to be between the two positions. The two positions are nothing but initial and final positions. You say initial and final positions only. Between the initial and final position only, distance and displacement, I'll give you both at a time. Displacement, right? See, here it is a displacement is a vector. Distance or displacement is nothing but a scalar. You remember first point here, it is a scalar here, and it is a vector. Everyone here, vector. I'll tell you why vector and why scalar. See, distance and displacement are to be between the two positions. That we can say the two positions are nothing but we can say initial and as well as final positions. Same here also, same initial and final. Suppose the person actually at a position A, the person want to reach a B position, right? See, he can go directly like this. Yes, he can go directly like this. And he can also go in the zigzag way, like, yes, we can take, yes, it is. See, look at here. In this case, I'll tell you both distance and displacement, I'll tell you. Look at here, it is to be like this, you take, and it reaches to B. So, what is the distance and what is the displacement? Distance is nothing but the total path covered by the body with irrespective direction. Look at, is there any particular direction for this? No. That may be curves, that may be some circle, look at, some circle, some curves. It is irrespective direction, there is no particular direction. So the distance is nothing but the total path covered by the body with irrespective directions, which we can call as a distance. That's what, here there is no particular direction, therefore it comes under a scalar. Yes, magnitude is there. Yes, we can measure this total length. Yes, it is 5 centimeter, 3 centimeter, 5 centimeter, like this is, yes, we can. So that your distance is nothing but the total path covered by the body with irrespective directions. Now, what is the displacement? Displacement is nothing but it is the shortest path covered by the body with respective direction. Look at, there is a particular direction is there. The person can go directly and the person can go like this also. So that's what it is. So displacement is the, it is a straight line represented as a displacement. And I'll give you another example here. Here suppose the person is at a position A and he want to go B. He can go directly. Yes, it is a displacement. And he can also go like this. He reaches to C and he may reaches to like this. Yes, in this look at, distance is nothing but a, you remember here, distance is nothing but a AC plus you say BC, it is a distance. And where is the displacement? Sir, what is the displacement here? Straight line and it is with respect to direction, which we can say AB is the displacement. That's what here. See, some curves and with irrespective directions are there, you say distance is the scalar. That is the distance, the total path covered by the body with irrespective directions. And here, let us, we should write a units. Every time we should write all physical quantities units as well as dimensional formulas. Already we finished the chapter, then also I'll tell you, because it is also very very important. In CGS system, distance is measured in centimeter. MKS system, it is measured in meter. And dimensional formula, we know that is only L. And here a displacement also, write here units, same as distance, MKS, which comes, it is meter. And the dimensional formula is nothing but a L. So this is the distance and displacement. You remember distance and displacements are related to between the two positions, that is initial and final. These are the related statements. It is the shortest path covered with respect to direction, and it is a displaced distance is nothing but that is a total path covered by the body with irrespective direction between the two positions. See, I'll give you an example related to this. It is also very very important. See, first example now I am giving. If a particle is moving from A to B along a straight line, see the straight line, no, Again, distance and displacement. What is the distance and what is the displacement? You remember, distance and displacement are to be between the two positions only. So that here, in this case, the distance is equal to, because it is a straight line, no? We can say displacement, because it is only straight line motion along a strain, because the position is same. That we can say first, initial and final. So the distance and displacements are related to between the two initial and final positions. So that for a straight line, distance is equal to displacement. It is one example. Like you go for a second example. Suppose if I give a one semicircle, yes, semicircle. The person can go from A to B along a straight line, and the person can go along the curve also. Like he can go. Say, remember, for the curves, I told you just now, if any curves are there, that related to distance. And a straight line is there, yes, it is a respective direction is there, that is related to displacement. So that in this case, you take the radius is r, so that distance is equal to semicircle, distance is nothing but AB, you write your curve, it is AB curve. So what is the distance, sir, in this case? Circumference of a circle we know 2 pi r. What about semicircle? That we can say half of the semicircle, half of the circle, half of the circle circumference, so that it is becomes a pi r, because circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. For the semicircle, what happens? In that half you take as a pi r. And here displacement is what happens here. Displacement is AB straighter, straight you take, straight line. You write here straight line is equal to r plus r. It may get to r, right? So that there is a one question is there, the ratio of distance by displacement. Distance by displacement, it is very very important. It is you take as pi r by 2 r. So r cancel, pi by 2. Pi is nothing but 3.14. therefore, if you cancel, we may get 1.57. the value of distance by displacement is 1.57. you say your distance by displacement is, it is greater than or equal to 1, because it is almost 1.57, no, it is greater than 1, so that we can say greater than or equal to 1. Distance by displacement. Sometimes he may ask you displacement by distance. Yes, you take a displacement by distance also. That is another question is there, that we can say displacement by distance. Is it okay? Like this way, we have the questions related to distance and displacement. Distance is a scalar and a displacement is a vector. So this is the two examples related to distance and displacement. Like this, we have other examples also related to distance and displacement. Okay, we'll see the next examples also. So this is the distance and displacement examples. And coming to the next examples, I'll give you. Say, suppose you take here one thing. Actually, there is a one very very important is distance and displacement. That is, distance is always will get the positive, whereas displacement, it may be positive, may be negative, may be zero. So the positive values, we can say this is the one positive, and it is also, we can say positive. For a displacement, I am telling, so the displacement may be positive, may be negative. We can write like this. See, you say here a displacement, right? It is maybe positive, and it's maybe negative, and it may be zero, right? See, positive values are, we know this, all are positive, distance, displacements are positive. And you remember, distance is always only positive and will not get zero, you remember, and will not get a negative also. See, will not get zero, will not get a negative, always positive it is. See, for this also example I'll give you. Suppose you take a circle. Suppose the person is moving in a given a circle like this. Say from a point A, if he is moving like this and he reaches to the same position A, distance and displacements are to be between the two positions. Sir, what happens? Look at here, displacement. What will happen? Displacement. Here you say final minus initial position for a displacement. Look at, initial is A, and again he reaches to the same final position, so that both the positions are same, no? Zero. Displacement is nothing but a, you say it is a, here actually the person is moving through the circle like this. So that final minus initial, we can also say like this. So that initial is the A and final also A. You want to write A minus A. The positions are same. And here, what about distance? So the distance is nothing but a total path, no? That is for a circumference of a circle. You say distance is nothing but a circumference of a circle. For this circumference, you say radius is R. So it is becomes 2 pi R. That's what I want to say. Distance is always will get a positive, whereas displacement is zero. Suppose I'll give you another example for this. Suppose, say one person is at a position A, and here he started from here and is going towards a is going to a shop. You say there is a one shop is located at a 1 kilometer distance. Shop is going and is getting something, so you want to buy something, and he went to shop and there is a shop is closed. Then again he returned back to the same position. Again he returns to the same position. See, so actually from A position to B is the distance is 1 kilometer, and again the person is returned to the same initial position. So that there is a distance and displacements are what happens. Look at, distance is nothing but a total path, no? That is a 1 kilometer is towards a shop. Again from he started from shop to is a initial position. So that 1 kilometer becomes 2 kilometers. What about displacement? Yes, again it is the initial and final positions are same. He started at A and again he reaches to the same position, so that the displacement may be zero like this. That's what your distance and displacements. Remember, distance is always will get a positive, will not get a zero, and will not get a negative. Whereas displacement, we may get a positive, we may get a negative, we may get a zero. So this is the zero example displacements. Right here, what about negative displacement? Let us will see negative displacement also. I'll give you, that is negative. When we'll get the negative displacement? Look at, that's what here. Suppose you take a one tower, that is a tower height is h. Therefore, if a body projected vertically up above the tower, from the above the tower, so that the body reaches to a certain position, that position is you say x. After reaching that certain position, again the body returns and it reaches to the foot of the tower. Foot of the tower. So that the actually it is projected up, but it is moving opposite to the original direction. You say this is the height is h, right? And it is x. Total will be x plus h. We can take like this, shall I? So what is the distance and what is the displacement for this case? Look at, displacement is nothing but a, you say displacement is, that is x minus, because it is actually original is projected up, but the path is opposite to the original one. So you say minus of x plus h. So displacement is equal to x minus of minus h. So displacement is equal to, we can say, minus h. So in this case, negative displacement. And we'll move to distance. So the distance is nothing but a total path, that is x and the x plus h. You say x plus h. So we may get 2x plus h. This is the distance. So that we can say here, distance and displacement. Again, displacement, we may get a negative, we may get a zero, and we may get a positive. And as well as the distance is always it is only positive. So these are the conclusion related to distance and displacements, right? These are the examples, number of examples are there here. So you go through this all examples, then you will get the clear idea related to distance and displacement. So this is the today's class, and thank you very much. And suppose you go through this all, then it is help you in the next classes. Thank you very much.